All right, what is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. It's currently Saturday, I think the 16th, and it's finally getting cold in Florida. It's 50 degrees out right now, so it's pretty chilly, and we're having our pre-workout right now. I've been waiting now just because, I don't know, I like to take it right before I go into the gym because by the time I'm done with my warm-up sets and getting to my working sets, it's starting to kick in at that point instead of like it kicking in during my warm-up sets when there's no point for that. So we're gonna do two scoops today. And last time I had PR Breaker, I had the cotton candy, but now we have the blue Raz, just as good. It's very good. So two scoops today, 300 milligrams of caffeine, 5 grams of creatine, yeah. So 8 grams of citrulline malate and 3.2 grams of beta alanine. So that's what's in PR Breaker, if you were wondering. Gonna shake this up. Today we have some deadlifts followed by some bench. So that's why I have my heels. Awesome. Yeah. So deadlifts and then bench. I think 3x6 on deadlifts and then a 4x6 on bench. And I think I'm only working up to 275 on deadlifts. And then for bench, I think I'm going up, working up to 195 for the 4x6. Pause bench, of course. And then I've got some accessory work after that. So I'm gonna take you guys through my main lifts, the deadlifts and the bench. And then I'm gonna give you guys some tips, some cues, kind of make this more of an informative video, kind of do a voiceover for this. Of some things that I'm thinking about when going into my lifts, because there's definitely more to lifts than just picking up the weight or dropping it, you know. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy. I hope you guys find something useful from this. I'm not saying you guys need to copy my exact form. I'm saying these are things I think about, some things you should think about as well, but change them a little bit for your own form, so that way you guys are getting the best lift possible. All right, what is going on, guys? So we're gonna do this voiceover real quick on some bench and deadlift tips, starting out with the deadlift. First thing is gonna be foot placement. For sumo, you're gonna go a little bit wider. Here, you can't really see it, but I set up at an outside ring, and that's where my shins are placed at. Second, you're gonna be looking at hand placement. My middle finger is where the knurling meets the smoother part of the bar, so that's where I put it. As you guys go into the actual lift, as you guys could see before, you basically want to get a neutral spine and then sink your hips down a little bit, which will help in assisting to get to that neutral spine. Once you get to that neutral spine position with your hips a little bit lower, you want to think about bringing your chest up and kind of looking up. You'll see I'll just like look kind of straight up. But that will help with keeping that neutral spine throughout the whole thing and avoiding lower back rounding and a possible injury. Here you guys can see the setup again. You can kind of see the rings now. You'll see my grip, kind of where the knurling meets the smooth part of the bar. And then sink hips down here, chest up, and pull. Lock out at the top completely, and then come back down, start over. So you guys can see the full motion. I was doing sets of six here, which were pretty okay, I guess. My sumo form's not too, it's all right, but thing with sumo is you can go pretty narrow or pretty wide. I have a little bit of a narrower stance for sumo, but a lot of people do go a little bit wider and angle the feet out even more. Alright, so we're about to be moving on to bench now, and one of the first things with bench is obviously getting your grip on the bar. I go pretty wide grip, helps with the shorter range of motion, it helps me lift more weight. There's a ring there where I put my index finger. Second, you're replacing your upper back into the bench, and then scooting your feet all the way back right here. You want to try to get your feet as flat as possible. For like USAPL, you need to have your heels on the ground, so that's a focus. Lift off, and you try to stay tight the whole time. Here you'll see my bar path, keeping that angle, kind of thinking about keeping my elbows at like 45 degrees. And then after that, you want to think about your leg drive as well. So when you are pushing back, you'll see my legs kind of tense up each time. Here we're looking at like a side angle so you can see it better. So you want to get positioned on your upper back or your rear delts. You don't really want much of your back touching the bench at all, honestly. So pushing back here, I use bands to make it to help with grip and keeping a tighter form throughout the whole thing. Then you're going to be bringing your feet down. Try to keep that arch the whole time. Stay tight. Here I'm wearing a belt. You guys can wear one if you want. It's all personal preference. Sometimes I do find that it helps me keep tighter throughout the whole thing. Here's another way you can see kind of bar path. You're going to, as you're coming down, you're going to go down and right almost and bring it closer to your the top of your abdomen. And then as you push back up, you want to push back over. Think about pushing back up and over towards the top of your chest. So it has sort of a slanted bar path. And yeah, that's going to be all. I hope you guys enjoyed that and found something useful from it.
Sure, I haven't waited in a while because my scale was dead, but I'm guessing that I'm sitting roughly around 180 pounds right now. My weight hasn't really been increasing because I haven't really been trying to push it that much, but my strength has been increasing, so I have no reason really to push up my calories at all because it would just be kind of, I don't know, pointless. I'd just be gaining fat, especially because my training is still going well. Today was definitely a tough day, but that's all right. We got it done. We hit the weights that I wanted to hit. That's based on the program and everything, so I'm okay with that. But back to like my physique and everything. I don't know if you guys saw it, but Jeff Nippard released a video kind of about how he's going about body recomp. And I wasn't very happy with my physique, so I was getting kind of chubby. Wasn't too happy with that. So I was sitting at roughly 3,300 calories beforehand, so I kind of dropped that down, going based off of what Jeff Nippard said, like kind of like how he estimates it. I dropped him down to 2,700. I know that's like a huge difference, but my weight really has not dropped that much. I pushed up my protein, so I'm getting roughly on training days like 200 to 220 grams of protein per day, so I'm prioritizing that, so I'm making sure I'm not losing any muscle. My carbs are a little bit lower. They're roughly around like 325, I want to say. And fats are sitting around 60 something. I'm just going based off of my head, like memory and everything. So those may not be exact numbers, but I know for sure, like protein, since that obviously is a main priority, that I am getting roughly 200 to 220 grams per day. And I don't know, based on that, it kind of looked like it has been working. Like my strength has still been increasing, and I think that has been the best I've ever looked throughout this whole bulk as I've put on some weight. So pretty happy with that. Today, like I said, it was pretty tough, but that's all right. Hope you guys did find something useful from some of those tips. For deadlift, my form's not 100% where I want it to be yet, but those are still some of the things I think about. And throughout the whole time, like even if my form may slip up a little bit, I'm like, Obviously, as you guys get to higher reps and stuff like that, like I was doing sets of six, so like as you get to the later reps, you're fatigued and everything, and you're getting tired, so your form may slip up a little bit. But that's when it's most important that you guys are thinking about those things to keep your form solid, so you don't injure yourself, which I'm trying definitely to not do again because that sucked. So that's what I'm doing right now. I didn't realize my window was down, But yeah, hope you guys did enjoy. If you guys want to see a new full day of eating, I know I did one recently, but if you want to see a new one with what I'm doing for the body recomp, basically how my macros are now and everything like that, just let me know down below. But other than that, let me know what you guys want to see. I definitely want to put out some videos that you guys want and that you guys want to see. So I hope this video was one of those things that could help somebody. Even if it only helped one person, that's all right. But you guys know what to do. Like, subscribe, comment down below, share with friends. We're almost at 350 subscribers. It's pretty cool. So thank you to everyone for watching. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day. I'll see you in the next one. And remember to never settle.